Welcome, beautiful souls of this world. It's your girl CoolieBabii. I done know the tinga already, and I'm here today with two beautiful souls that chose to follow God's order and walk in God's will and become one in matrimony. And listen, y'all gonna get to talk to them and see them for yourself. But I just wanna welcome my beautiful Uncle Ryan and his now beautiful bride, his now beautiful queen, Miss Indira.
I just swear that I'll always be there. I'd give anything and everything, and I will always care. Through weakness and strength, better for worse, I will love you with every beat of my heart. From this moment, life has begun. From this moment, you are the one. Right beside you is where I belong. From this moment on, from this moment.
Father, we thank you for this wonderful day, this great occasion. We come to celebrate. We come to celebrate love and life. We come to celebrate your goodness to two young people who have found each other according to your plan and unto your will. Mm-hmm. So now we commit these evening's proceedings, fun and laughter and food and gaiety, all in your hands. Yes. And may your spirit lead us and make it a memorable evening. One that will not be forgotten, only because you are good and your mercies endure forever. Bless this couple and bless everyone who is going to do something, say something, or give something in Jesus' name. Amen.
Holy, holy, holy.
So as you know, we are here, as I said, with my beautiful uncle and now my beautiful newly auntie. I'm so happy that you guys are in matrimony because I feel that this was under God's will and it happened, so it had to be God's will.
And how you guys feel being, you know, married, finally married, because I know you guys were, you know,
talking
and communicating and stuff. So how do you guys feel now being married and being one with God?
Very happy, satisfied, fulfilling, and all of the above.
I love that. What about you, Uncle Ryan?
Same thing. From day one, he's just the godsend. He does his work and he brings us together. And this is a combination of everything so far.
Yes.
But the gloriness is yet to come.
Absolutely.
The best is yet to come.
The best.
And I would have nobody else with me to go through life's journey but her being by my side. So let's tackle life.
I love that. So was it like a struggle? Were there any struggles before you guys made it to this very point?
Oh, yes.
Tell me about it.
Had a lot of nothing was a bed of roses.
Mm-hmm.
It was a lot of commitment in terms of communication and all of that. There were times when we were silent. There were times when we would not answer each other's calls. But I'm thank God we're here today. We made it.
I did too. And now that you mentioned that, you guys were distant before, right?
Yes.
So this is like actually you guys really coming physically together.
Yes.
That's so beautiful and amazing.
I never really believe in long distance relationships. Not for me anyway.
But you know, for other people, obviously for you too, it works, you know?
Yes.
And as I said, if it's God's will, no matter the distance, it's going to work.
He's the one that perseveres. Because there were times in our relationships from the beginning time that we didn't think it was going to mature into a relationship because of the fact that a million miles away from each other.
And it had to be hard,
And single lives now becoming intertwined with one life.
I love that.
A lot of steps had to come about. And we both had to make decisions that would gratify. But we all took it in God's word hand, and He said, we'll make this work.
Mm-hmm.
And day one to now is still the same. I would not change
anything.
And
that's beautiful. So would you guys, like, do you guys have any, like, short-term goals, marriage-wise, or long-term goals, or, you know?
Go ahead,
Laura. Yes, we do. We want to have kids.
Mm-hmm.
A lot.
Oh, and I know twins really your family.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Twins.
I have some twins coming. That's amazing. Oh, wow. Okay. Do you guys want a boy first or a girl?
It really doesn't matter.
Whatever God has planned for us, we take it. And I'm not saying she has a daughter and a son. I'm saying we have a daughter and a son because I treat them just like
they're part of her and they came from her.
Exactly.
So, and her life before, I can't change anything in her life before. I accept everything that she's coming with. and I love them just like my own. That's my son and that's my daughter.
Mm-hmm. You said it perfect, because when you marry her, you marry the beautiful kids too. So that's beautiful.
I just love the union.
And you guys really give me hope, because really, honestly, with the marriages that happened around my life, starting with my mom and dad, they never got married. But not only their relationship, but a lot of marriages around my life I've seen allowed me to have doubt when it comes to marriage. And at one point, I was like, I ain't getting married. You know,
I had that same belief of not getting married, but like I said earlier in the when we was outside there, I leave it all up to God. He's gonna find. We all have someone that's gonna be our soulmate, whether it's now, today, tomorrow, or years from now. You don't have to say anything. Just put your, if you really want to. You give it to God and let Him answer your questions in your prayer.
Amen to
and
that.
I wouldn't trade for anything in this world.
I wouldn't either. This is my auntie, y'all. Oh, I love my auntie. Y'all know CoolieBabii Beatins. You see it right there. But before we wrap it up, do you have anything that you guys would give advice to young people that might be newlyweds, or people that are young people that are thinking about going down the marriage road? What's something that you would tell?
Well, she's been through marriage already, so she can morally answer this question.
Well, I would say it is tough. I wouldn't say it's a bed of roses or a piece of cake. It has to do with a lot of hard work, commitment, and come out of your comfort zone sometimes. And to make this work, you don't have to always think about yourself. Mm-hmm. Always think about the other person's feeling as well.
Right.
And anybody who is in a long distance relationship and you don't have hope, I can say that you can have some hope. You have hope, just like us. We never thought that anything would have, you know, materialize or anything, but everything that we talked about and we prayed about, we can see now, see the manifestation.
Yes.
Of everything.
I always
that
said 2020
is happening.
I would get married. Mm-hmm.
They didn't.
All years like, yeah, he called and he said, believe me on this, we are gonna get engaged and we are gonna get married in 2020.
And what's today's date?
10/17/2020.
10 what? And it happened. They manifested. Manifestation is real. Affirming.
Know your heart. Know your partner's heart. And be equally yoked.
Be
presence.
In one of accord.
Well, there you have it, young people. Be equally yoked and of one. Not two, not three. One accord.
Because black can never be white and white can never be black.
It's not gonna work. So thank y'all for joining in, and thank you for helping me to wish my beautiful auntie and uncle a beautiful life together of prosperity, happiness, love, faithfulness, all the fruits of the spirit. We love y'all so much. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you. Be blessed.
Y'all stay good. CoolieBabii Day, another thing already. Peace.